Hello, my name is Stacey Eberschlag and I work at Toon Boom Animation. And what I'm going to do in this video today is just quickly go over the preferences that I like to use. Most of the work that I do is cutout, so these are basically my default preferences in Harmony. So if you're using a Mac, you're going to go under Stage Preferences. And if you're going to use Windows, you're going to go under Edit Preferences. So I'm going to start by choosing my Preference button. Along the top, we have a whole bunch of tabs. We're not going to do anything yet under the shortcuts. We're going to skip over to General. And one of the preferences that I like to definitely have on when I'm working is under the Save option, Enable. Basically, you want to be able to save your work as you're going along. Interval, I like to have it on for maybe 5 minutes. I don't want to lose more than 5 minutes worth of work. Focus on mouse enter allows me to move my mouse cursor from maybe the camera view to the timeline, and it will automatically make wherever my mouse is hovering active. Shortcut zooms on mouse, well, basically means wherever your mouse is and when you zoom in, it zooms in directly to that point. So if I wanted to zoom into the word interval, of course, if my mouse was over interval, I would zoom right into it. If I wanted to zoom into invert scroll direction, and when I'm in Harmony and I'm zooming, it would directly go into that. Stop motion keyframes. Basically, it just keeps everything as a key without any tweening. And default separate positions for pegs. Basically, any new peg that you create in Harmony, you want to make sure that it is separate unless you are doing a 3D move. All right. Let's move over to camera. I'm not going to make any changes in this window. I'm going to skip over to where it says drawing. And I want my onion skin to be normal, as opposed to a shade. This is what I prefer. Under timeline, I want to reduce indentation in the timeline. So when I'm reading the names of the elements, they don't stretch out into the middle of the screen. They sort of stack themselves better on top of each other. And let me just go over to advanced. I'm going to turn this one off. Basically, I don't want to be able to animate the drawings. Every drawing will require a peg if this is turned off. And I'm going to turn on this one, support overlay and underlay arts, which basically gives me additional layers right here. Right now, I just have line art and color art. Turn that on. And finally, two more things. You notice that the screen is this dark looking interface. I'm going to turn this one off under the General tab. Use dark style. And it's going to require me to relaunch the software. And when I do, everything will be in the old classic gray. I've been using the software for a very long time. I've got comfortable in the traditional gray interface. So I typically, when you're watching videos done by me, you will notice I'm in the gray. So this is how you switch it over. Okay, thank you for your time and enjoy your experience with Harmony.